Patuloy, we will continue our investment. We're discovering the articles of faith. So, we are already on the lesson 6. And we entitled this as The Tragedy of Sin. Yan po yung ating pag-aaralan. So, before we start, we ask everybody to assist them so that we can reopen the lesson if you want. Father God, Lord, in heaven, Lord, thank you for this time that you have given us to study once again, Lord, the foundations of being a Christian. Lord, we thank you for the 2015 that you have given to us, giving us a strong physical and spiritual body. Lord, we pray that you will give us wisdom and knowledge so that we can understand the lesson that we will cover for this afternoon. This is our prayer. This is our prayer in the mighty name of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ. Meron na po bang handout ng lahat? So as we continue the study for the for today, the our theme, discovering the article of our faith. So on this lesson, we will study regarding what happened, what took place in the Garden of Eden. Why we are sinners. And then so many another lessons that we can study. So, as I start, may I request everybody to please read our introduction. All of us, sabay-sabay po tayo. Begin.
We believe that man was created in sin under the law of his maker, but by the divine inspiration, man is sinless and bad state. In consequence of which, all mankind are now sinners, not by constraint, but by choice, and therefore under just condemnation without defense or excuse.
So this is the fall of man. We will begin. Okay, so we have the book. It says, in response to an article in the London Times, What's Wrong with the World? This was written by G.K. Chesterton. One reader wrote a brief letter to the editor when he read this book. Then he said, I am. When he answered the question, what's wrong with the world? Then yours truly, G.F. Chesterton. See, we can see that the proof of sin's existence is found. We can see the sin's existence in our culture. We can see it in our society. We can see it in our home, and lastly, we can see it in every person. So, do you agree with this, that the sin, we can see it everywhere?
Yes.
Next. Okay. When Adam, when he chose to disobey God's command concerning the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, every human to be born in the future was affected. All aspects of creation was affected. So, because of sin, from Adam, all the generation became generation of sinners. And with that sin, it is a block, the blessings of God. So, this is just the introduction. Then this lesson focuses on the choice of sin and the personal guilt of all mankind born after the fall. So we will study, and your you can see now the state of Adam's block. So, point number one, the state of Adam's creation. So we can see that Adam is created in innocence. Okay. We can see there that up until God's assessment of man's creation, everything was judged by same praise, then God saw that it was good. So everything that God created, we knew that it was good. Di ba? Alam po natin lahat ng commendation ng Panginoon pag may kasya ng says that it was good. So, but creation without man was incomplete. So, all the things that God created was good, but without man, God wanted an administrator. So, someone which it has dominion of creation could be entrusted. So, that's why God, what purpose my God created Adam is to be the administrator of God's creation. So, we can see, God's assessment of man's creation, everything he made is judged by the same good. After man's creation, God's assessment changed. We can see here, and God saw everything that he made, and behold, it was very good. So it was good before, now it became very good. Because man is the finishing touch of God's creation. When Adam and Eve were created, God said creation is now very good. So Adam and Eve, when they were created, the completeness of the creation was 100%. So we can see here that what does innocent mean? We have a point, some point A in the handout. You can see here what does blank mean, what's the word innocent. So we can see here. The word innocence in Article 6 refers to more than just an absence of guilt, where there is not even a hint of sin or imperfection in Adam. So when God created Adam, Adam has no sin in his life. Do you agree with that?
Amen.
So on that creation, the state of Adam's creation, he was created in innocence and there was no hint of sin in his life also. So Adam and Eve's interaction with God was open and personal in every way that the other human beings have never been enjoyed. So, pati sila yung kasama ng Panginoon. Para pa kanila nakaka-fellowship ang Panginoon na like today. That we can talk to God in prayers before they talk to God personally. He said, in Genesis 3:8 indicates that this walking in the garden in the cool of the day was a regular, if not daily, opportunity for fellowship between Adam and Eve. So we know that they are staying in the Garden of Eden. See, you may wonder who is that guy. That guy is a theologian, Charles Riley. So he is a Christian. But he's a theologian. So he has some, he calls prayer state of Adam. So he has 3 points of explanation regarding the prayer state of Adam. It was unconfirmed because he has never neither passed nor failed the test. Then the state of Adam is creation. His holiness is not the nature of the creator. So it's like there's a difference. And then the holiness, because he was more than innocent. At that time when they haven't sinned against God, they have this holiness in their life, in their being. So next one. So man created without sin, yet the capacity of free choice or free will. So you can see that his spiritual state was that of innocence, so he was guilty of nothing. The capacity of free choice. The potential to do wrong in present. So, but without sin, they cannot do wrong. That's why they are holy in the sight of God before. Okay, so for the top illustration, a man who goes through a trial after being charged with some crime may be found innocent, and in fact be innocent. Being innocent, however, does not mean he is incapable of doing crime. So, as a today, there were accused persons, but they are innocent sometimes. They are falsely accused. So, if the man is innocent, so he has nothing to worry. He just did it for himself. So, in that case, this lady is not innocent. Is it an investigation? Huh? So, you know this lady?
The police.
This is the police. Okay, so we are done with the topic of this innocent. So, it's also what does innocent not mean? So, ano naman yung hindi proper na ano naman? Ano? So, we can see it that the man came from the dust, the bread of life, so yes, body and soul. So, it's the illustration only. You can see. Okay, so this is not what innocent means. Huh? That his innocence means free from sin and his spiritual state, but short in his character like God, in whom it is impossible to sin because of perfect character. This was the state in which Adam was created, innocent of sin, but with the capacity of moral choice. So, let's hear what? This is the topic number two. We can say the point two is the sinfulness of Adam, voluntary transgression. So Adam's choice. So the lack there in point number two is choice. So what is it that made Adam sin so bad? Ano ba yung ginawa ni Adam? When he had the opportunity for pure, unhindered fellowship and relationship with God, Adam voluntarily rejected it through a disobedient choice. So we can learn later kung ano yung nangyari. That's why bakba kasalanan ni Adam ay napapagdala. So, we can see here the difference, no? But it says here, Eve's disobedience was a result of deception. So, Eve was deceived. So, hindi niya alam. Kasi, it was a deception. It's not, wala na siyang, ano ba, sa, wala pa siyang nakitang, ano, kumbaga, result bago siya nagkaroon ng, ano. So, doon siya na-deceive ni Satan. And Adam's disobedience was the result of a choice made with clear understanding. So, the sin of Adam is mas mabigat kaysa sa yung nangyari kay Eve. His choice was certainly voluntary transgression. So, what was the sin of Adam is the result of his choice. What does transgression mean? Transgression is the only one of many words in the Bible which is to describe sin. It means to rebel, which is exactly what the first couple did, they rebel against God. Also, this is the first sin mentioned in the Bible. So, we will continue on Psalm 8. We can see that sin is a violation of God's law. So, sin is a violation of God's law. It is very clear. Yeah. Adam didn't originate sin. Hindi naman nagalit kay Adam yung sin, but surely he participated when given the opportunity. This is what God said to Adam. But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. So this is the command. It's the command of God to Adam when he created him He created Eve from the ribs of Adam. Adam's transgression, rebellion, could be clearer, violated God's law. Yeah. So, next. Say God has given him a command. So, we can see that God is very clear to the isama na sila kina kay Adam kung ano yung mga habili niya, no? So, Adam cannot believe that, but it's not clear to him. Okay, so we will continue. Man was created with a moral being, subject to the law of what is right. And the question is, what is the law? So, that's the law of the Lord. So, there are four things, the several things that the law cannot be. So, it cannot be your norm. Because there's a... Pag may sarili tayong law, kagulo na, di ba? Hindi, batas ko to eh. So, then every man could be a law unto himself. So, everybody could be a law. Then, it cannot be the law of happiness. As sinners, happiness is not always or synonymous to truthness. So, it's a big difference in the world. Then the third one, it cannot be the moral order of the universe. Such an obstruction can neither impose law nor inflict penalty for breaking it. So, cannot be the law, she cannot be on a personal basis. Kailangan, so may susunod din tayo. So, with the law, sino ang nagbigay ng ano? So, I hope kilala niyo ba yan. So, from Charles Hodge, he's a systematic theologian also. So, he said, from this theology, he said, the law must be the rule of a rational being. Who is the rational being? He is God, who is infinite, eternal, and unchangeable in his perfection. That's why the law is given by God, so not anybody. So, naalam po natin, nasusundan po natin. Then, the word makes it very clear that God, that the man has broken God's law. So let's continue. It says in Leviticus 6:14, if they shall confess their iniquity and the iniquity of their fathers with their trespass which they can trespass against me, and that also they have walked contrary unto me. So we can see that the man has broken God's law by not following him. We can see also in Romans 3:9, what then we are better than they? No, in no wise. For we have before wrote both Jews and Gentiles that they are all under sin. You can notice here that all are under sin. So that man has broken God's law because all are under sin. Now that we know that the things, whoever the law says, it says them who are under the law. That every mouth may be stopped and all the world may become guilty before God. So nakikita po natin talaga noon, ang kasalanan ay violation sa batas ng Panginoon. So that's the point A that we have. It's a violation. That sin is a violation on God's law. So it's been, should be clear that B, sin is a nature as well as an act. So makikita natin sa sub-point B that sin is a nature as well as an act. Man's sinful actions are not the full extent of sin in man. His nature is sinful as well. So, that's why we have sinful nature in our body. Kasi, this is where we belong. We inherited the sin from Adam. That's why we were born sinners. So, say, our acts of sin spring from a nature that is bent towards sin. A corrupt tree can only bring forth evil fruit. So this is the Torah saying in Matthew 7:17. Every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt fruit bringeth forth evil fruit. So set the fruits and just for the So you know what are the fruits, right? These are very popular personalities in the Philippines. This is the former president, and this is a former head of the opposition. Under investigation. So, Bina is not there because it's under investigation. So, let's continue. Man's sinful actions are not the punishment of sin. In man, his nature is sinful as well, so we have said that earlier. So, we can see that in Matthew, it teaches us that behind or not all lies. Behind murder lies, there's hatred. Behind adultery lies sinful lust. So, nakikita natin, di ba, yung sin, yung nature natin, tsaka yung nagiging act when we sin. When we sin. So, that hatred, it, kumbaga, nagre-result siya sa murder. If we have this sinful lust, it is resulting to adultery. So, we can see, nakikita natin kung ano yung nagiging fruit, di ba? Kung ano yung, ano, yung what's follows sin. So, the heart is the deceitful above all things, and desperately wicked. Who can know it? So, it's from Jeremiah 17:9. So, as far as the man's nature is concerned, there's a true saying, sinasabi ko lang ni Pastor. The heart of the problem is the problem of the heart. So, yes, because there's a problem. Okay, let's continue. So, it's already in your handout also, you can check that. Sin is a character, sins are the character. So, it's just a comparison of sin is the center, sins are the circumference. Sin is the source, sins are the secretion, sin is the root, sins are the fruit. So, nasabi na natin yan. Sin is the producer, sins are the product. Sin is the old nature, sins are the manifestations. Sin is the start, sins are its offspring. Sin is the fountain, sins are its flow. Sin is what we are, sins are what we have done. So, it's clear that since we are created sinners, when we do something of the sin, there's a result of these are the sins. Okay, so, third one, letter C, is sin is essentially selfishness. So, there's a question here, it says, what makes man sin? Pride, unbelief, disobedience. These are the sins, no? They don't cause sin. So these are already the result of sin. So it says in Isaiah 36, all we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way. So it's like being alone. You are on your own. And the Lord had laid on him the iniquity. Essence of sin has been the love of self. So, maybe if you heard that one, I love me, I love myself. So, say, act of selfishness already. Except when you're limiting, I love me the least. No, it's I love me. This love of self puts all interest ahead of God's interest. Contrary to God's instructing us in Matthew 22:37, Jesus said unto him, thou shalt the Lord, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul. So I think it's essentially selfishness because whatever the things, as I mentioned kanina umaga, that we should put God first in our lives, right? So that selfishness is the essence of sin is evident also from the fact that all of the forms of sin can be traced selfishness as its sources. So, marami kang maalala sa ako, di ba, sa Bible? Yun yung mag-asawang pinatay ng Panginoon dahil hindi sila naging ano. Yung nag-concern na sila. Ananias and Sapphira, we can see their selfishness because they did not give what is good to the Lord, what they had promised. At inalala pa rin yung sarili nila. Okay? So, sa the verses in 2 Timothy, it's all we know that the last days, the perilous time shall come, for men shall be lovers of their own selves. Covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, innocent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers, and pleasures more than the lovers of God. So, we can see here, na sin is revealing in the self. Begins in itself. That's why sin is manifesting in every person, right? Kasi nandiyan na yan sa puso natin eh. We are one of that one. That's why we can see what happened in the life of Adam. So, this only our situation. And one thing, we can see at an early age, right? This is true happening. hindi naman natin tinuruan yung mga bata na magiging ay selfish. Nagmamali niya sa kanilang mga, sa kanilang sarili. Kasi they have that also, just like each and every one of us. I don't know kung sino nakikita ng kaumpan. Kasi yun mo ba? Kaya kapatid niyang nag-medical. So we can see now at their names. Yung selfishness, nag-umpisa na yan. That's why tinuturuan tayo ng mga magulang natin na huwag tayo maging madalo. Iba na lang kung madalo kung ano, pera. It's because they cannot teach their children. Is there a doing, right?
Right.
Kung maging madalo, kung madalo naman sila. So, we can never learn from parents that are not doing what they are asking us to do. So, thank God na hindi naman ako. So Jesus, the only one who lives his life without sin. So this is the example. Exemplify unselfishness. John 3:5-30 says, I came from my own self doing nothing. As I hear, I judge. In my judgment is just because I seek not my own will, but the will of the Father which is me. So God, if He is, kung may makasalanan ng Panginoon, pwede niyang piliin hindi ko matay sa cross, di ba? But He is a sinless person. That's why it's not His own na ano na nangyari, kundi yung will ng God the Father. That's why He died on the cross, because if it's His will, He will not do it. But since He is sinless, nakikita natin na yung example na hindi niya pwede kong isipin yung kanyang sarili. So, ginawa niya yung will ng Father. Ephesians 2:4 says, but God, who is rich in mercy for His great love, wherewith He loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace, you are saved. And hath raised up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. The Apostle Paul appeals to Jesus' selfless sacrifice as the basics for his exhortation to the Philippians. So, this is the, so the Ephesians thing. The Ephesians. So, we will continue. Adam is given the capacity to make moral decisions. Just like the angels, right? God has given the angels the higher authority. And just like Lucifer and millions of other angels, he made the wrong choice. Like the angels, Adam kept not his first estate. In contrast with God, you cannot sin. So, yeah. Before the resignation. So, it was the same, but Adam knew exactly what his choice was. He made a choice based on his selfish desires. He may have been ignorant for the full scope of the consequence of the choice, but he did know it was against the mandate of the Holy God. So, alam naman natin, di ba, nung kinahabilinan si Adam na huwag kayo kumakain niya. So, what you think? If Adam did not eat the fruit and only Eve, it should be a different story, right? Because he's been a faithful. Kumbaga, sinunod niya yung mandate ng Panginoon not to eat the fruit, the good and evil. But what did he do? Sinunod niya yung kanyang asawa. So, we are done with point 2. Third point, we will have the scope of Adam's consequence. It said, all mankind are now sinners of choice. There are various terms used to describe this sin nature that every human being has. So, makikita ko natin yung kung anong klase, different kind of sins, ano yung mga sinasabi ng Bible regarding sa mga kasalanan na ating na-inherit. Okay. We have the inherited sins, no? This is the parents, godparents of Adam and Eve. Sin nature focuses on the fact that sin has filled the entire nature, emphasis the difference between the roots. So, sinful nature and the fruit, so sinful acts. So, nakikita natin dito, sinabi natin kanina na dahil may sinful nature, meron tayong pinanggalingan na makasalanan ng nature. Nagkakaroon tayo ng product ng sin. This is the fruit of sin, yung mga anger, yung mga hatred. Nagkaka-product yan ng mas malala. Okay, the original sin, Adam's original sin, produced by a moral corruption of nature that was transmitted by inheritance to every succeeding generation. So the original sin came from Adam, and then we also have the inherited sin. Ito yung inaano natin. We can see the illustration, no? We can say inherited sin. So, then also, once it is imputed sin na, ano yan, nag-exist na sa atin. So, meron tayong pinama, meron na yung nasa atin. So, pwede nyo kasi the difference. So, imputed sin or guilt. So, there are two verses there. 1 John 1:9-10. So, personal sin. Meron tayong mga personal sin. Inherited corruption, galing kay Adam. So we can see the point that sins extends to everyone. So we can see here that there's a word related to depravity. What does depravity means or samaan? Man is not only sinners because Adam sinned, but the truth is that we are not only sinners by nature inherited from Adam, but we are sinners by personal choice. So nakita natin yung mga personal sin natin. So Romans 1:21, because that when they knew God, they glorified Him not as God, neither were thankful. So we can have here the total depravity. What does it mean? Kasamaan. All aspects of man's being are affected by sin. So from the previous illustrations, we saw a while ago that from Adam, all the generations became sinners. So we can enter the verse here. For this purpose God gave them unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that what is against the nature. So we have also the second point here is all people are affected by sins. So just follow in your handout, meron din yung mga blank. So, total depravity means these things. That all aspects of man's being is affected by sin. So, wala akong part ng ating as a human that is not affected by sin. Okay, we will... So what does total depravity does not mean naman? So this is the fourth meaning that every person has shown their depravity as much as they could. So hindi naman lahat ng mga tao ay talagang pag sinabi mong masamang tao ay ginagawa niya lahat ng kasamaan, di ba? That sinners do not have the conscience concerning God. So ang mga makasalanan ay hindi naman wala silang conscience, di ba? Kasi lahat naman tayo galing doon. That sinners will indulge in every form of sin. So, see, it doesn't mean that since you are a sinner, you can do every sin that is in the world. So, that's why it's saying that total depravity does not mean these things. And that depraved people do not perform actions that are good in the sight of others and even in the sight of God. So, tama ba, diba? Marami namang hindi saved pero they are doing good for the sake of people. And then, God is only seeing that. Only they are not a child of God, but we can see that hindi naman lahat ng sabi natin unsaved sinners ay nagagawa ng lahat na lang ay kasamaan. So, relative goodness exists in people to the extent that they do good works that they appreciated by others. But nothing that anyone can do will gain salvation or merit or favor in the sight of the Holy God. So, it's not by the works that they can be having a salvational merit na isa-save sila ng Panginoon. It's only by the grace of God that a man can be saved and by accepting God, Jesus Christ as the personal Savior. So, yeah, illustration that all mankind are not sinners. It's like the word. Okay. We can see here, sin includes pollution as well as hell. This is the point two. Okay. It's in Romans 1. Well knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worth of death, not only the same, but their pleasure in them that are good. So, sin includes pollution. So, in the mind, no? These people, they not only know what they do that is wrong, that they take satisfaction in doing it anyway, but boldness sinful men have before an omnipotent and judging God. So, we can see in days na gumagawa na sila ng masama, mas gusto pa nila, di ba? Kumbaga, nag-enjoy sila. So, we can really see that it includes pollution sa mga tao. So this pollution in the mind of people are showing several ways. See, you can see the illustration. Sometimes it's beautiful, right? And sabi niya, wonderful, marvelous, beautiful. But they kept it. What are you talking about? It's look wrong in the soul. Ganyan ang tao, di ba? Alam naman nilang masama. Parang na-enjoy pa nila. Oh, it's beautiful. See the perspective of the world. That they thought it was very good, but in the sight of others, it's not. So, sin includes pollution. We can see here lang what I'm saying. Pollution. So, makikita mo natin yung ano ba yung nag-include sa pollution na yan sa buhay ng isang tao. So, a man's darkened understanding. Yan. You can see yung mga reference verses there. Hindi na po natin ano pa rin hindi ko masyadong makatala. So, man's darkened understanding. Because polluted na lang yung kanyang buhay. So, pagkatiwala po ako ganyan po the darkened understanding. Hindi niya maintindihan. So, point two, people with youth imaginations. Yung mga mindset ng tao ngayon. Di ba? Nandiyan na lang sa utak ng tao yan. Mga yan. Murder, theft, adultery, greed, folly. Okay, number three is degrading passions. So, dun sa Romans 1:26, sabi kasi dito, that may yung kumbaga even as the women, sabi niya, anong nangyayari ngayon, di ba? Same-sex marriage.
Right? Amen.
So, nakita na natin kung gano'ng polluted na ang mundo natin dahil sa kasalanan. Okay. Perverted women, sometimes hindi na, kahit kung ano yung tama, what is good, they are not doing what is wrong, they are doing. So, recently, nakikita natin yung pollution ng mind ng tao. And unwholesome speech. You can see, even in televisions, right? When they talk to each other, it's not an example already. They talk too much and talk nonsense. So, one more is defiled mind and conscience. So, ito yung pinakamahirap dyan. Defiled na yung mind niya, pati yung conscience niya, defiled pa. So, ano bang gagawin niya? Be careful when you serve people like this, ha?
Mark Simpson.
So, you know this lady, right? You know what this lady said? Oprah Winfrey once said that open intuition will direct you. If it feels right, it's probably right. So, yan yung paniniwala nila. No? Even here, follow your instinct. That is the way true wisdom manifests itself. So, ano bang true wisdom na yung Christian, di ba? The fear of the Lord, right? It's the
meaning
of wisdom. But for the world, follow your instinct. Alam mo tama, yun yung gawin mo. Right? Which is contrary to the teachings of the Bible. So, this is definitely wrong, right? What she's saying is definitely wrong. This pollution was in David's mind when he wrote Psalms 51:7. He said, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Purge me with the hyssop and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow. So yun yung ano nga ni David. Kasi nga, naano niya sa sarili niya na siya ay makasalanan. So, that is the Point number three, this hope of freedom's consequence will make mankind turn now sinners and unjust. So we will proceed to the last point of our study today. Under just condemnation without defense or excuse. So you can put there condemnation. Under the just condemnation without defense or excuse. So man's sin has serious consequences before God, right? For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who have the truth in unrighteousness. Then Romans 1:19 it says, because that which may be known to God is manifest in them, for God hath showed it unto them. Romans 1:20. For the invisible things of Him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even His eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. So, ipinakasal ako ng Panginoon, di ba? Sabi niya dito that no sin is small, it is against an infinite God and may have consequences immeasurable. No grain of sand is small in the mechanism of the watch. So this is from Hudson Taylor. So sino naman yan si Hudson Taylor? Yeah. So siya ay isang pioneer missionary this world. Parang marami natin kung sino. So he said that no sin is small. Sin is sin in the sight of God. There's no white lies, there's no one sin, there's no one real sin, there's no 1 million real sin, right? All are sin. Kaya sabi ng mga kung magnakaw ka daw, magnakaw ka ng malalaki si Maris. So, this is supposed to be. Don't just commit the sin, okay? So, malaki na tayo ng tawas. The surety of the judgment. So, alam naman natin that because of sin, there is a judgment. There are few things more strongly in the Bible than the reality of God's work as judge. So, ayun yan kay James Powell, who is that guy? James I. Powell. Yeah. Knowing God. So, you can see the book, Knowing God. So, this guy is not James Powell. Bumili siya ng libro. This is the author. Yeah, right? See? It's a proof that the book, from his book, says that there are few things strong in the Bible than the reality of God's word. Yes. So, this is the reality of James. But at least it's in the book, right? And the person who bought the book. Okay, you can see the surety of the judgment. So, God's judgment is for everyone, right? There is no exemption. Wala pong exempted sa judgment ng Panginoon. So, that's why we are sinners. We are judges. Supposed to be judges. But God made a way that we are judges. Not because we are sinners, but because we will be doing what is the will of the Lord. There are those that doubt the coming of the judgment. They have seen personal, present, all things history. No, it's stated in 2 Peter 3:3, knowing this first that this shall come in the last days. The scoffers walking after their own lust, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. So there's a surety of the judgment of God. Every sinner. Secondly, last, the severity of the judgment. So, kala po ang ano ng judgment sa mga tao? Kala what will God do? Yes. We know that the punishment of sin is death, right? And this death is in the death of men, in the death, in hell. So, we can see how, kung gaano yung kaserious ang punishment ng Panginoon sa mga kasalanan ng tao. But because of God's love, right? Ito yung ginawa niya sa, ano? He which will by judgment to be avoided without purpose. Sin is truly terrible and has destroyed lives and families and nations. But man's choice to sin has no hope. God by surprise. So God already knew that man will sin against him. And at that point, God also has a plan of redemption for those people that will accept their sins and confess it to God. It is rooted in the work of the Savior, Jesus Christ, at the cross of Calvary.
Amen.
But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of the judgment and perdition of ungodly men. But, beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day it is the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long suffering to us, not willing that any should perish, but all should be come to repentance. So, makikita natin yung plan talaga ng Panginoon because of the of his love to us. That ayaw niyang ano natin ito eh, tenasin natin yung judgment. God doesn't want us to experience the judgment. So that's why he has given us Jesus Christ to die on the cross of Calvary. Come on Christ today, allow him to be your Savior, the only one who can wash your sins. Okay? So, simple demonstration. Kami pa kayo ng mga sorry, so salvation is very important to every human. And we know that sin is also manifesting in the lives of every person. And we know that God is a loving God. That's why He gave His only begotten Son to save us from our sin. So that's it for the lesson 6. Thank you.